हेलो क्लास 10th स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट रिफ्रैक्शन बाय स्फेरिकल लेंसेस। अर्लियर वी हैव स्टडीड मिरर्स, नाउ वी विल स्टडी अबाउट स्फेरिकल लेंसेस। इन लेंसेस रिफ्रैक्शन टेक्स प्लेस बिकॉज दे हैव टू सर्फेसेस। दिस थिंग यू हैव ऑब्जर्वड इन डेली स्पेसेस वेयर सम पीपल आर यूजिंग स्पेक्टिकल्स फॉर रीडिंग। Using watchmaker is using a magnifying glass for making repairing your watch that you must have studying. They are using a lens. What is a lens and how does it bend light rays? That we will study in this lecture. Transparent material bound by two surfaces of which one or both surfaces are spherical forms a lens. This picture also you can see these two types of lenses are there. This one is called convex lens, this is called concave lens. Why they are different one, that we will study. A simple lens is two spherical surfaces bulging outwards. Such a lens is called a double convex lens. You see, this is double convex lens bulging outwards. So this is called make of two spherical surfaces, and that's why it is called bulging outwards, and this is called double convex lens. We are denoting as a convex lens in normal condition. Another convex lenses are also called converging lenses because light coming from here will get converges at one single point, that is called focus, that we will study further. This is called converging. From here parallel rays are coming and they all are converging from the same point. That's why this is also called as converging lens. Similarly, a double concave lens is bounded by two spherical surfaces curved inwards. It is thicker at the edges than at the middle. You see, this is concave lens, thicker at edges and thinner at middle. And this is again made up of two spherical surfaces inwards. This is called concave lens and this is called diverging lens because in this case all rays are parallel rays are coming and they are refracting like this, and when we extend these refractive rays, you see again a one single point is there, that is a divergent point. So these are diverging from here, so that's why this is called as a diverging lens. Two lenses are there, but in common language called it as a single concave lens. In both the lenses you observe that this line which is passing through optical center, that is not refracting anywhere, this is going straight from the lens, this is not refracting. Similarly in concave lens also, this line, whatever ray is coming from and passing through optical center, that is going without diverging or without converging. This is the property of lens. Then the line, an imaginary line, straight line passing through the two centers of the curvature of a lens is called its principal axis. This is what is center of curvature, that you must have studied in mirror also. The spherical surface is, when completed this sphere, you will get one center. When you complete this sphere, you will get one center. That point is called as the spherical center of curvature. In this case, two spherical center of curvatures are there because two spherical surfaces are there. Similarly, here also, this completed, you will get one center of curvature. And when you complete this, you will get one center of curvature. And when this line, the line which is passing through center of curvature and optical center, that is called as the principal axis. Further use this point you must have already studied in mirrors, that is called optical center, which is in the center of the lens. Then what is aperture? Aperture, it is a ray of light passes through the optical center of a lens passes without suffering any deviation. The effective diameter of the circular outline of a spherical lens is called as aperture. That we had studied already in mirror. This one is called as the aperture. effective rays are going through the that part of the surface that is called effective diameter, and this we will called as aperture. Here radius is, here such lenses we are considering that are thin lenses with small apertures. The radius of curvature is more and aperture is less. In theory we are studying this type of lenses. The distance of the principal focus from the optical center of a lens is called its focal length. One more point you must have known, that you must understand that when this diverging here you will getting a focus f2. Similarly, when rays are coming from this side, you there they will diverge from this focus, this point, and this will called as f1. So in case of lenses there are two focuses, f1 and f2, and from O to f1 the distance is called focal length. Again, in this case also, when rays are coming from this side and they will diverge, so you will get one point here as f2. So this there, that is called focus. This in this concave lens also there are two focuses. Thank you.